important. The believer grows to become a laborer, and the laborer grows to become a soldier. Apostle Paul addresses Archippus and he says, my fellow soldier, our fellow soldier. Amen. Whoever came into contact with Philemon, they were blessed and they were growing. You can see his wife, and she was helping him out in the ministry. You can see Philemon, from a believer, he becomes a fellow laborer of Apostle Paul. And the person who, Archippus, who was attached to Philemon, we see that he has gone one more step and he has become a fellow soldier for Christ. Amen. God wants each one of us to become a fellow soldier. God wants each one of us to become soldiers in his army. Who is a soldier? A soldier is a person who is always alert. A soldier is a person who will stand up at the time of crisis. He will not run away. He will endure the problems. If you are going through problems in your work spot, if you are going through problems in your business, if you are going through problems in your marriage, don't run away. Don't try to retreat back. Stand. Face the enemy. Because Jesus is with you. We got to be fellow soldiers in the army. Hallelujah. This is what has captured my attention and made me prepare this message of we got to grow. God. Apostle Paul looks at Archippus and he says, my fellow soldier. Amen. Let me, you know, take you down to verse 23 and 24 and take you to the real, you know, this is the real, you know, the important point in this message. The Apostle Paul goes on to say, Epaphras, my fellow prisoner in Christ Jesus, greets you, as do Mark, Aristarchus, Demas, Luke, my fellow laborers. Amen. You can see all the disciples of Apostle Paul, they were all growing. They were all just not in the stage of believers, just attending church and then running away home. Just even for a 2-hour service in the church, there are people who come late, half an hour, they come late and go early. Maybe they are just coming there to give attendance. But here we see the disciples of Apostle Paul, they were all growing from glory to glory. This is very beautiful. Apostle Paul looks at Archippus and he says, fellow soldier. But he looks at Epaphras and he says, my fellow prisoner. Hallelujah. You got to be ready to go to prison for Jesus Christ. You got to be ready to suffer for Jesus Christ. You should not murmur. You should not complain. Why am I going through this path? Because the Bible very clearly says, blessed are those who suffer for my sake. Amen. You are blessed. You are blessed not because you have a BMW. You are blessed not because you are staying in America. You are blessed not because you own a big apartment. You are blessed because you are suffering for the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. That is the definition of blessing given in the Bible. But the worldly definitions for blessing is totally different. It's almost savings that you have. What property that you have. And it is gauged and then it is measured according to it. But in the Bible, Jesus says, you are blessed if you are persecuted. You are blessed if you are going through suffering. You are blessed if you are just going to endure till the end. And then the Lord says, listen to me, okay? The Lord says, I will give to each one of you according to your works. We are accountable for our life. We are accountable for our life. We have come to the end of this year, my dear Christian, my dear friends, my dear youth pastor, my dear youngsters, I'm speaking with you. There are many who go and worship without reading the Bible, without praying, without having a fellowship, and without having fruits in their life. What you are in your living room at home is very important to what you are there on the platform, on the stage. You've got to be fruitful at home, inside the living room. You've got to be a good person for your dad. You've got to be a good son for your mom. You've got to be a good daughter. You've got to be a good wife. You've got to be a good husband. Before we take the mic to preach on the pulpit, let me tell you, the anointing just flows. Why do you think Philemon became a laborer and then he was just growing, and all those who were coming into contact with Philemon were blessed? That is because he had a good leader. He had Apostle Paul as a leader who just passed on this anointing. It just went down, percolated. The anointing percolated. It percolates down the church. Even a message heard on the video, a message heard on the audio can transform your life. How much are we growing? Apostle Paul looked at Archippus and he said, fellow soldier. Apostle Paul looked at Epaphras and he said, my fellow prisoner. Hallelujah. Amen. And this Apostle Paul, from where did he write this book of Philemon? From the prison. My God and my God and my God. Look at the anointing in his life. He was an aged person. He was an old person, elderly man. It says here, you know, Philemon chapter 1 verse 9. Yet, for love's sake, I rather appeal to you, being such a one as Paul, the aged and now also a prisoner of Jesus Christ. Let this message speak with you. Let us check out our lives, how much we are growing. Can Jesus look at us and say,